Hello, everybody, and welcome to the last in our series of Buds and Spawn live stream shows. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. If you're new to Buds and Spawn, we started off as a live music night in Sheffield. We started promoting events in 2019 and managed to land ourselves some money from the Arts Council to put on some shows in 2020. So you can imagine how well that's gone. Instead of just not doing anything, we decided to take all of our stuff online. So this is the fourth of the shows that we've created with that Arts Council funding. So this evening, we've got three fabulous bands for you. First of all, we've got Rosh, who's a Sheffield artist with whom we've recorded a fabulous woodland session in Sheffield's Ecclesall Woods. We welcome back Perhaps Contraption, who have now been able to make the live session video that we aimed to make for the last show, but lockdown thwarted us. And we've also got the display team, who are here to share their brand new music videos that we've made with them. We'll be having interviews with each of our artists as usual, and there is plenty of opportunity for you to ask questions if you want to use the YouTube chat. We've got Aitch, who will be keeping an eye on everybody's messages as they come through. So also, if you have a look underneath the video and the show more section, you will have links then to buy the band's music, their merch. If you really like what you hear, we have tip jars available for each of the artists if you wanted, seeing as you can't take them to the bar and buy them a drink in our virtual world, then you can pop a few quid in the tip jar and we'll pass those on to the band afterwards. You can also sign up to the Buds and Spawn mailing list to find out a bit more of everything about what we've got planned for the future. So without further ado, we're going to introduce ourselves by the power of the magic microphone. So, hi everybody, I'm Laura from Buds and Spawn.
Hi, I'm Steph from Perhaps Contraption.
Hi, I'm Rosh and I sing and play guitar.
Hi friends, it's me, Stan, from the display team.
Oh, Josh, you're muted.
Hi, it's me, Josh, from the display team.
Hey!
Thanks. Hi, I'm Lucy, and I play melodeon and sing with Rosh.
Thanks, Lucy. I'm Mickey from Perhaps Contraption.
Hi, I'm H from Buds and Spawn.
Hello, I'm Christo from Perhaps Contraption. Just going to pass this back up.
Thank you, everybody. Well done. I'm going to put that down now. So first off, we're going to have a chat with Rosh and Lucy, who also plays with Rosh. You might recognise Rosh if you watched our last live stream show, as he was featured playing bass for Cosmic Triceratops, and other musicians in other gig goers in Sheffield will probably recognise him as well from King Capiche, but he's actually been hiding some serious talent of his own. So we're going to have a chat with Rosh and Lucy before we watch the film. Just a reminder to everybody, if you've got questions or feedback, please do put them in the YouTube chat. So if everybody but Rosh and Lucy could switch off their cameras and mics, that would be brilliant. Hello.
Hi.
So Rosh, your first EP only came out last year. You've been playing in bands in Sheffield for years, and it feels like you've really emerged, like suddenly fully formed as a songwriter. Like when we did our little interview for our blog, you talked about this serendipitous period in which you like found your mojo as a songwriter. Do you want to tell us a little bit more about that?
Oh, well, I definitely didn't emerge fully formed. I've had many years of being crap. Don't worry. Yeah, it took me a long time to have the confidence to actually present music under my own name that I had written myself. Many years of just playing in my room and not really showing anyone what I'd written. But also, I feel like it took me a long time to figure out what I wanted to say and how I wanted to say it and be happy with that. And I guess that serendipitous period wasn't last year, not many serendipitous.
I don't know anybody that would talk about 2020 as a serendipitous period.
Yeah, exactly. I a few years ago, I went to India, not to find myself. I have family in India, very lucky to have lots of family in India, and I went to visit them and I stayed there for a while and I took a guitar with me and I had lots of free time to practice and unselfconsciously play and learn to sing. And that was a really, really fruitful time. And after that, I had a whole bunch of songs that I had ready and I started thinking about being ready to present them.
Yes, it's fantastic. And I'm so glad that you have. I mean, Lucy, how did you first come across Rosh's music?
It's interesting. I knew Rosh as a friend for quite a long time before I had any inkling at all that he was a really stonking songwriter. He kept that really quiet. And we'd been hanging out for a few years, you know, going to parties, going to the pub. And I can't remember the exact moment, Rosh, but there was a time when Rosh was like, "Oi, I've got some songs. Do you want to play them with me?" And I was like, "Oh, okay." You know, and I, you know, similar to Rosh, sort of had been doing some songwriting in my pants, in my room, not letting them out to the world. And there was a little period where we tentatively like sort of explored some music together. And yeah, that was really the first I heard of it was through a friendship. And then Rosh kind of, I don't know, maybe it aligned with that serendipitous period when Rosh was like, okay, I need to get these songs out there. That's how I first heard about his songwriting. I've been to see him in King Capiche a few years ago at the Picture House, which was an amazing gig. And I was like, wow, my friend's a really cool musician. Who knew?
Excellent.
So, yeah.
Oh, that's really nice. That's such a sweet thing to hear. Thank you.
So like I said, you released your first EP, See Them Rise, last year. So who did you work with on the EP other than Lucy Rosh, and how was it releasing that in the middle of a pandemic?
Well, Lucy unfortunately wasn't on that record, but she is on the next one.
Yeah.
But I basically just worked with lots of friends. I'm very, very lucky to have lots of talented friends who actually saw something in my songs when I didn't and helped me record them. So I played, I recorded the record with Tim from King Capiche, who plays guitar, and my friend Paul, who has a studio in Doncaster, and he gave me some studio time. So yes, I recorded with them and they played on it as well. Tim is all over the record with his guitar playing, and my friend Pete played drums. So yeah, it was a very, very much a collective effort to make it, to realise it.
Yeah. You're really lucky to, I mean, you've got a really high calibre of musicians around you, which I think is going to be very obvious to people when we watch the film shortly. So Lucy, you're an established folk musician and melodeon player in your own right. And Ric, who also plays on the film, plays with Bobby Lee and has played with Kill the Captains and a 20-foot squid band, loads and loads of really, really good Sheffield bands. Lucy, do you want to tell us a little bit more about the other projects you're involved in? Lucy, do you
want to hear me? Okay.
I can, yes.
I do, but I feel like I might be breaking up. If you can hear me, that's great. I'll keep talking. I've been doing kind of folk music my whole life, but in more recent years, I've been getting into performing more, which has been great fun. And at the moment, I'm in a trio with an amazing singer called Rosie Hood, who's also a Sheffield-based folk singer and musician, along with a fiddle player called Nicol. And we've been sort of touring for the last couple of years and kind of making a go of it as a trio, which is brilliant. And that's much more sort of traditional folk songs and some songwriting as well from Rosie. And I've done a bit of recording with a show called 3 Acres and a Cow, who, if you haven't heard of them, check them out. It's an incredible, incredible show about the history of land rights in England, sort of set up by a guy called Robin Gray. And it's just fantastic. And that's been a real privilege to work on as well.
Brilliant, thanks. So we were really pleased to get a bit of extra funding from Launchpad Projects, which is what made it possible for us to make this extra film with you for the fourth live stream. And we spent a lovely day in Ecclesall Woods with our filmmaker, Goms Nyakale, and Paul Blakeman, who did the sound. How was that experience for you guys?
Oh, it was beautiful. I have to thank you, Laura, for making it happen. And when you asked, how do you want to make the film, I was like, can we do it outside? And that's obviously a bit of a logistical nightmare, but Tom's and Paul and yourself made it happen. It was so much fun, and I think everyone will enjoy all the bird song that's also on the recording. It's a really beautiful thing.
Really glad that made it in. It was a wonderful day. It was a part of the woods I've never been to before, so that was a real treat. It was just past the bit they always stop at, and it was just a gorgeous, gorgeous place to be for the day.
Lovely. Rosh, do you want to tell us a little bit about the songs that we're going to hear?
Yeah, so the first song, Old Road, is about having the courage to not listen to the voice in your head who tells you you are weak and powerless, and also considering, thinking about all the choices you make in life, how they preclude you being able to make other choices, and just considering what your life would be if you'd made other choices. The second song, Rewild, is about the desecration of the natural world, the loss of wild places, and how when we lose those places, we lose something of what's wild in us as well. The last song, This Is What You Asked For, I wrote that last time I was in India with my family. It's about how there's a class of people who deny dignity and justice to people, and in India lots of people have been denied dignity for so long. The same class of people here say you can't have justice or dignity, and it's saying this is the world you've made and it's going to come back to bite you in the ass.
I would say awesome, but that sounds great. Brilliant. So let's take a look at the film. Thank you.
make this bond to not turn back. So many roads have turned to traps. If we don't meet when you get there, at least for a time we walk together.
Thank you.
say you want war. You say you want war. This is what you ask for. All against all. All against all. This is what you ask for.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, guys. So have we got any feedback or comments for people on the call? How about you, Josh?
Sure. That was beautiful, first of all. Thank you very much. I'm a big fan of nature. It was lovely to see a performance like that in a tranquil setting. I noticed the birds in the background. What type of bird was that?
Well, I think Rosh can tell you now.
It's not a chaffinch, it's a chiff-chaff.
Oh.
Which is not a kind of finch, it's a kind of chaff.
Right.
Exactly. Yeah, we've resolved that one fully. Exactly. Excellent. Mickey, I think you had something you'd like to say.
Yeah, well, yeah, if ever some music suited the location, that was a wonderful place to record that, and some excellent guitar playing and singing from Rosh as well. Really lovely.
Thanks. And Stanley?
Yeah, absolutely gorgeous. Some really lovely harmonies, really lovely chords, beautiful songwriting generally. So thank you, Rosh & Co, for that spellbinding performance. One thing I did notice was that you're playing a Martin & Co DCX 1KE guitar. What first drew you to that specific guitar, and would you recommend this guitar for the folks at home?
That's amazing that you know that. I got it given as a birthday gift. So I wasn't drawn to it, but the person who bought it for me was, which I imagine they were drawn to its buttery fretting ease and beautiful resonant sound.
Wonderful, a fine gift.
I'm not endorsing Martin.
Maybe the guitar was drawn to you, Rosh.
Yes, definitely.
Yes. H, have we got any feedback from the chat? Any questions?
No questions, but we've got some fun comments, I guess. Belch 1889 says it's like Spring Watch but better music. Keir Cooper says the alternative Blair Witch ending. Paul Stevens says the cats are digging it, digging the birds. Sound Tonic, I definitely want to see these guys live. And the display team say, tell those birds to learn the lyrics or shut up.
Rude. Yeah. Let's just clarify. Yes. These representatives of the display team will have to take that up with the social media representative of the display team. Yes, quite. And I just wanted to ask a little bit about, one thing that stood out to me from the shoot is that Ric, who played the guitar and the fiddle on that last track, was saying that he didn't really play the fiddle. And it didn't sound like that to me from that tune.
All lies. Yeah, he turned up to practice one day and said, I don't know how to play the fiddle, but I've got some ideas. And he whipped it out and honestly just came up with the most amazing arrangement, and it just lifted that song so much.
Yeah, he had a demo of the song and he learned to play the fiddle to the demo. So he did an amazing job.
Incredible. So what's next for you guys? What's on the horizon this year?
It would be great to play to actual human beings. I'm very looking forward to that, though I don't have any plans yet.
We're working on it.
And I've also recorded most of a new album, which hopefully will come out by the end of the summer. And it'll be much bigger arrangements. This is a very stripped back renditions of some of the songs off the new album, but the album's going to have lots of instruments and more complex arrangements on it.
Brilliant. I would very, very much look forward to that. Thank you, guys. So if you enjoyed that, remember to look at the text underneath the YouTube video that will show you the links for Rosh's social media, for his Bandcamp, and also for the tip jar if you'd like to throw him a few quid to say thank you, well done. That would be lovely. So next, we're going to welcome back Perhaps Contraption, who were fabulous on our last live stream show, but we hadn't managed to get to make the thing that we wanted to make for this project because of the last lockdown. They now have. So really excited that we've got this to share. So I'm going to hand over to H to have a chat with Christo, Steph and Mickey. If everybody else could switch off their mics and cameras, please.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
Hi.
Lovely to see you again.
Lovely to see you too.
New video. What was it? You filmed it in the premises studios in London. What was it like doing that in during lockdown or just outside of?
Oh, it was lovely. In fact, I'm here right now in the premises studio, or one of
wow,
representing.
Oh my God, there's a piano and a PA, and it's very exciting. There's windows. and the premises is sort of our musical home. We've been rehearsing here for 10 years, and I work here as well. So it's we've always made music here. So it's
home.
Yeah, it's a very comfortable place for us to do stuff.
So, yeah. Excellent. So tell us about the music itself that you chose to film.
Well, we did a few songs. With three of the songs were, they're songs that sort of fell off the radar a bit. Was that the phrase? Probably not. But they had sort of disappeared and we'd never really recorded them. We had gigged them a bit, but not all of them. And so this was sort of a way of bringing them back to life. And then one of the other ones was a cover by John Adams, who is an American composer. Who wants to talk about him?
We need gin, don't we?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's the fanboy, isn't he?
He's really a John Adams fan. But yeah. Funny story about this particular piece that we recorded. The day before I auditioned for the band, I went to see the band play live and they played the song, and I just remember being like, oh, there's quite a lot of notes in that. Like there's quite a lot there, you know, no pressure or anything, sort of expecting that I'd have to show up the next day and play it like that, but so it's been kind of nice to have that time to really sort of get together and learn it, dare I say, properly. I mean, for any John Adams fans out there, you know, I guess it's a, I don't want to be compared too much, but I think we put our own stamp on it. And it's been so much fun to sort of, well, get together and play it again. We sort of played around with it during lockdown, but actually being in the same room playing it is a whole different kettle of fish. So yeah, loads of fun.
Some definite joy going on, definitely. Yeah. So what's the future? You've got an album and a stage show?
Yeah, we were actually with Buds and Spawn, we were meant to be bringing our theatre show Nearly Human to Sheffield to, I've forgotten the name of the venue, but a beautiful theatre in Sheffield. But obviously we couldn't do that. But yeah, we've got the album that is accompanying it. It's about 70% mixed. We're going to be releasing in September, all being well. And then we've also semi-recorded the songs that you're going to hear tonight in the studio. And they will be released as an EP. Probably at some point early next year. So yeah, there's lots of recording going on and we're building a new show which involves a pendulum.
Yeah, you mentioned the sand pendulum. Do tell.
Well, it's very early days, but we're creating a piece of music with an organisation in the Netherlands who create live experiences for people who are deaf. Well, not just for people who are deaf, but there's a whole kind of ecosystem that they're creating art for, and we're building a show with a pendulum that creates beautiful patterns, and we're adding some music to that process.
Oh, sounds amazing. So people get to watch the sand become an image as they're, yeah, fantastic.
Yeah, they create these beautiful mathematic figures that are related to music, we're going to relate our music to the patterns.
So there's been quite a lot of science music crossover for what you've been doing with Nearly Human and this new show. Sounds really exciting.
Yeah.
So what are you really looking forward to for the future?
I think it feels a bit like we're just coming a bit back to life after the lockdown, or certainly coming out of a cocoon that we were in. So it's just nice to start playing together again properly.
Yeah, and things opening up a little bit and you're getting back together and
Yeah. Looking forward to any gig.
Yes. Any well, gig on that, nice. Where can people see you perform?
We're going up to Durham Brass Festival in July. It's a bit of a trek for most of our fans in London, but you know, we're certainly looking forward to having a few days to play again together then. What else do we have, Christo?
And when is that? When's that festival?
That is July 8th. I think it's July. We're up in Durham for 5 days. I think it's July the 18th.
No, I think it ends on the 18th. I think it's the 13th
to the
18th. 13th. So we're up in Durham for 5 days. Apart from that, we don't have anything else.
Well, that's enough. 5 days of Durham bandness sounds awesome.
The County Durham tour.
Excellent. Well, it's a fab county. I'm sure you'll love it, and I'm sure people will come and see you. Well, thanks, guys, and let's take a look.
Hit it.
I'm gonna lift the spirit. Thank you. Scrimp and save out, stretch your arms, extend your ways, hold and hope, or rot and cope. Shake hands with me, shake hands with me.
Thanks, guys. That was fantastic. So taking some comments from people on the call, Rosh.
Yeah, it was a combination of like loads of my favorite things in music, odd time signatures, brass and vocal harmonies. I would love to stumble into a tent in Shambhala and find you playing and dance along.
Thank you.
Stanley?
Yeah, it's always absolutely a joy to see Perhaps Contraption play. It's such richly detailed and exciting music. And aside from this excellent music and really dynamic performance, I noticed you're very colourfully dressed. What is the concept behind your stage wear?
I think initially I just really like those colours. At first we were like, should we just wear those colours? And then it just sort of, from that palette, just rippled out. Yeah.
Then UKIP stole them.
I really do feel that you're wearing
that. No, UKIP's more purpley. We're a bit more maroony.
Yeah, that's the difference. That's the one difference between us.
We have no affiliation with UKIP, ladies and gentlemen.
Lucy, you've got a question to ask. Oh, Lucy, can you hear me? Oh, internet. It's not our friend today. Oh, I don't think you're there. Aitch, what about questions from the...
I'm worried about my internet connection.
Oh. Yeah, so Lucy, on your behalf, you wanted to ask about the musical influences of the band. So who wants to tell Lucy about the influences that you guys have got?
Well, personally, I'm really into a lot of 70s prog music, as you can probably guess. Early Genesis and King Crimson and Zappa and Beefheart are sort of my musical home. So that definitely runs through what I'm into. Mickey and Steph might have some other thoughts.
I'm going to go 80s sort of. I'm going to go for Oingo Boingo and XTC. I'll go for those two.
Yeah, I mean, when I first heard Perhaps Contraption, because I joined a bit later than the rest of the guys, it was that sort of mix of, because I love the sort of 70s prog stuff as well. And I think as we've kind of gone along, we've been influenced by so many other genres and other bands as well. So it's kind of become this one explosion of kind of everything. And hopefully those four songs you can kind of hear are different influences there. That was rambly, I'm sorry.
Thanks, Steph. HM, we've got questions from the YouTube chat and comments from the audience.
Yep. We've got Keir Cooper, who says, what's the Adams piece called?
Short Ride in a Fast Machine, which is originally written for orchestra. So this is an arrangement of it by our sax player, Jin. So it's not exactly the same, but there's a lot of elements that we learned off by heart from Short Ride in a Fast Machine.
And Soundtonic says, do they have to write it down to learn it?
Well, funnily enough, with this one, Jin, who did the arrangement, he made up some brilliant lyrics for the whole thing, and they were, I don't even know how to describe them, but they really just made it so easy to learn because of all the different, you know, syllables and everything. But in terms of the actual, the notes that we were playing, I was very lucky to say that in that whole thing, I think I had one note over and over again, which was nice. It's refreshing, I suppose, but it's just, as you can hear with that, rhythmically, we needed a bit of help from Jin, and maybe one day he'll be kind enough to publish his amazing lyrics on our site or something, because you'll have a good laugh, you'll enjoy them.
And one of the display team members who are on the call, has the coronavirus pandemic changed the way the band goes about composing? And if so, how have you adapted?
Oh, that's a hard question.
A hard question.
Because I think I probably haven't written as much for the band in the pandemic, but I think as we're coming back together, it suddenly seems more exciting to write now the pandemic is opening up. I think we wrote stuff for each other more in the pandemic. Maybe some of those ideas will plop up. Plop.
And we have another comment from said display team. I just got a text from Dominic Cummings. I can't wait to see Perhaps Contraption in Durham. And Rose Biggin says Durham Brass Festival is not going to know what hit it.
Yeah, yeah.
And a shout out for Anna Hawkins. Shout out for Anna Hawkins' 15-year-old lad who just gatecrashed the gig and is dancing behind her, bringing in the youth.
Yeah. Brilliant. Thank you very much, H. So if you enjoyed that, remember to have a look at the links in the video description. Click the words show more to see, unveil the huge list of links and credits that are underneath the video. And if you wanted to buy the band a drink, you can put a few quid in their tip jar. It's a PayPal money pool that you can drop money in, and we will pass all of that directly to the band after the show. So last but not least, the very last act of the Buds and Spawn live stream series, definitely not least, one of my personal very, very, very favourite acts. We are going to talk to the display team, who describe themselves as a high energy, high concept, high pitched band from London, which is our way of describing their music. But there's a lot more to say about them. So if everybody else could switch off their mics and cameras, I'm going to have a chat with Stanley and Josh. Hi, guys.
Hello.
Hello. So we'd really hoped right up until the very last minute that we were going to make this happen as an in-person gig. So we were still holding on to that hope when we got to January. And it's been fair to say that this pandemic's had a different impact for everybody, and unfortunately you guys haven't been able to get together and rehearse or record a live session because of shielding household members, so we looked at doing something completely different, and we've opted to make a couple of music videos. So which of you would like to tell us a little bit about the first video we're going to watch? Maybe Josh, you could tell us that.
Sure, I'm really glad you've asked. Well, it was made pretty much at home by Sam Wise, our trumpet player, and myself. We did it in our spare time, with me directing Sam and Sam compiling the images and manipulating them accordingly. It took a lot of work. Frankly, some of the shots took painstaking work.
Yeah.
And Sam did a fantastic job under pressure.
Lovely.
The track
that we're going to hear,
the track's called When.
And this is from your 2019 EP Spinner.
Correct.
So let's take a look at the first video.
Thank you.
Brilliant. So am I right in thinking that's the very first display team video?
That's absolutely right. And can I just say that while I have seen these videos before, seeing the first display team video here on the Buds and Spawn stream live for all the folks at home really adds to the excitement.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you, Stanley. I'm glad you think so. So I mentioned that track was from your Spinner EP that came out in 2019. And I came and saw you guys at your London tour date, I think, that Chaos Theory put on. You did actually do quite a big tour around that EP. What were your favourite bits of that tour?
Our London gig at Paper Dress Vintage was really good fun. The display team fully endorsed local promoters Chaos Theory and the City of London and thanked them for a wonderful evening.
Excellent.
And Josh?
Can I contribute?
Please do.
Well, Stan lives in Brighton.
That's true, I do.
And we played in Brighton on that tour at the Green Door store.
Nice.
The promoters that night were Fresh Lennons, and a big thank you has to go to them because it was a great night. The people in attendance that night were, as far as we could tell, from Brighton themselves, and that really did a lot to enhance the atmosphere of the gig.
Excellent. Well, it's a shame that I couldn't have made that one as well. Brighton just a little bit, a push too far from Sheffield. So you guys are usually uber disciplined regular rehearsers, aren't you? So it must have been a really tough year to not be able to get together and play music together. However, has that created a bit of time to thinking about new material and germinating new ideas? Josh, do you want to respond to that?
Sure. Well, we care deeply about delivering the best in performance concept solutions for all our fans to enjoy. One good thing about the pandemic experience has been that I've finally been able to sit down and focus on the backlog of new material I've amassed in recent years, but haven't had the time to develop properly. There's a lot of it, and I'm really looking forward to getting together with the band again to work on some of that new stuff as soon as possible.
Excellent. Well, I'm very much looking forward to hearing the results of that because I'm ready. I'm ready for some new display team material, it must be said. So have you got any idea when you might get to be able to rehearse again? What's on the horizon for you guys over the coming months, Stanley?
Well, we intend to rehearse as soon as all members of the display team are able, our aim being to bring high quality performance and musicianship to all fans as soon as is humanly possible. To this end, we're aiming to recruit an additional member to replace our former trombone player. Now, ideally, this person would be proficient in trombone, but saxophone would also be acceptable. Either way, our plan is to continue providing fans with a thrilling experience they've come to expect from Display Team live. And the next time you can do that, by the way, is at a gig in Brighton, 7:30, the 3rd of July, at the Prince Albert, promoted once again by Fresh Lennons. Do come.
Oh, that sounds very exciting. Yeah, I would love to come to Brighton in July. Probably not going to make it, but hopefully some people on the call, on the watching on YouTube, are placed in different places around the country and may be able to travel to said gig. Awesome. So we've got a second video that we've made from the Spinner EP. Josh, do you want to tell us a little bit about this track and how you've gone about making this video?
Sure. This is for another song by us, the Display Team, as you said, from Spinner. We teamed up with General MIDI, Stephen Cole himself from the band APAT. As you'll soon go to see, he's skilled as a video editor.
Yes.
And I mean, I think I'll let the video speak for itself.
I think that's very wise. Well, lovely to chat to you both. So let's take a look at the video.
Another drink. You spit open, tell me what you think. We're always there. I right or is your forehead well?
So people on the call, Christo, did you have anything you wanted to say?
Oh well, just I'm thrilled to enjoy your videos. The Display Team are one of my favorite bands in the world ever, and I would just love whatever you put out. I wanted to know a bit more about the process that you went through. I mean, it's quite a vague question. Anything you want to tell me about? How was it to create some videos?
Liberating.
Thank you, Josh. Excellent. And Rosh, would you like to chip in?
Yeah, I always like the combination of angular guitars and a brass section. I think they sound great together. And I have to ask for a friend as well about the first video. What's the significance of the canoe?
Mm. Where was the canoe? not an oblique question.
She told me to ask about the canoe.
Okay. That's a good question. Stan?
I do not have any knowledge of this canoe.
That totally cleared that up then. Brilliant. Thanks.
Mess with this.
And Steph?
I think Russian Doll might be my new favorite song, so it sounds brilliant. How many hours of editing went into that video?
Probably somewhere between 5 and 7. I didn't edit that.
I think it might have been a little bit more than that, Josh.
Right.
I think the wonderful Stephen Cole did a very fabulous job for us with that video. And I think we ought to give a little extra cheer for General Madi, Stephen Cole, for his contribution to that. Thank you, Stephen.
Thanks, Steve.
Yeah. And it was fab to be able to work with him again. I particularly love the way it started off looking really conventional and normal, and then before you know it, you're kind of slipping down this rabbit hole of wrong, which kind of sums up Stephen's approach, full stop. So, brilliant. So, questions from the audience. Have we done that already? I'm getting lost.
not yet.
Great. Questions from the audience, H.
So Mr. Tim Holmes says, have the Red Arrows ever been in touch about you purloining their name?
Not yet.
It's a genuine issue when trying to tag you into things on Facebook, just to say that the amount of other display teams that want me to tag them instead.
I do not believe we are in a state of copyright infringement at this stage.
At this stage.
We're keeping our eyes on it.
Thank you.
And Ruben Young says, I notice a lemon or lime, unclear which, in the music video. What gives citrus fruit their sour flavour?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Yeah.
I'll type that into Google and get back to you later.
One for Google, totally. Keir Cooper says, does the display team have subs or a manager in a suit on the side?
We're all the manager.
Paul Morricone says, do the display team notate any of the parts or is it all worked out by ear?
A combination of both.
Yeah.
Good answer. And Paul Morricone says, do the... Oh, hang on. No, I just said that. This is an opportunity to plug your next gig again. Because Keir Cooper says, when are you performing again?
Right. Well...
7:30 on the 3rd of July at the Prince Albert in Brighton. A gig played by Fresh Lennons.
Excellent. Thank you.
It'll be a great night.
Marvellous. Thank you. So if you enjoyed the Display Teens videos and you'd like to hear more, you can look at the links underneath the video. There's got a link to their Bandcamp. I highly recommend that you buy their albums as soon as possible and listen to them on repeat. And links to their socials and also to their tip jar if you would like to buy them a drink to say thank you for their excellent contribution this evening. So we're winding up the very last Buds and Spawn live stream show of this series anyway. I've got the obvious list of thank yous for those people that haven't been actually visible to you watching at home. So I'd particularly like to thank our Sheffield filmmakers, Smart Bander and Goms Nyakale, our soundest sound team, Paul Blakeman and Molly Clark, Simon at For the Lost PR, Stephen Cole at What Studio for basically helping me out with pretty much everything. Amy Holmes, who designed our wonderful magic microphones, and to Aitch and Kunal Singhal for basically keeping this all the show on the road through the various lockdowns and school closures and all sorts. And Tom, our producer, who has been a total rock throughout the whole thing. And all the wonderful artists that we've had involved in the project and the partner venues, Theatre Deli and Abbeydale Picture House. So what's next for us? Well, we're hoping to bring you some in-person shows in Sheffield in the autumn, showcasing the best of our local artists before we go back into branching out into bringing new artists into the city in 2022. So if you want to be kept up to date with what we're doing, please sign up to our mailing list. The link is below the video. And we're going to finish off with, I've made a little video just to remind us of all the other live stream shows that have happened and what we've done over the last 9 months. So I'd like to thank all my guests that have been on today, Stanley and Josh from the Display team, Christo, Mickey and Steph from Perhaps Contraption, Lucy and Roche from Roche, and my fabulous co-host H as well. So I'll get everybody to wave goodbye and we'll hand over to the final thank you video. Thanks everybody. Bye.
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 Hello, it's Raquel from Persona.
We catalog the days, each one numbered, distinct only by a unique symbol, not the mill of indistinction, a meaningless Tuesday or Friday.
One thing that I enjoyed about this project was getting to play a show that friends and family from around the world got to see. It was really nice and I loved it. Thanks so much. Bye.
It's your turn, Mike.
Hi chaps, it's Stuart from your favourite math rock, post-rock, post-metal Leeds bass promoters, Bad L Presents here. I just want to say thank you so much to Buds and Spawn for having me on one of their earlier shows. It was great to see just how much they managed to rally together the music scene and lots of bands and people from different places. It was a real honour to be part of it.
Hello, the Buds and Spawners, and Laura and the team. Thanks very much for everything you've done. It was a lovely series of events and I enjoyed all the music. And I'm really pleased that we were able to engage with the different people across the new network of people that you seem to have created, because otherwise I might not have spoke to any other musicians during this particular pandemic. So thanks for that. Bye.
Yeah, if you just pass us the microphone. Cheers, thank you.
Hello, I'm Chris from New Ghost. We were lucky enough to be included in the Buds and Spawn live streaming events. It was a wonderful opportunity, one of the best experiences we've had as a band. Obviously, there were only the two of us, but we were lucky enough to be included and had an amazing time. I think the results speak for themselves. Super professional, wonderfully put together. We're very lucky, very thankful to be included, and hopefully we can be included again.
Hi, I'm Chloe from Valve. Thank you, Buds and Spawn, for inviting us to be part of your project, and to Arts Council England for funding it. We really enjoyed meeting bands and musicians that we wouldn't normally meet. And it was fun to be able to create something and quite exciting to be part of it. So thank you very much.
Hello. It was really, really lovely and awesome to be able to meet and chat with some other musicians and promoters and lovely, lovely people, meet some new people and hear some music that I wouldn't have heard otherwise in a time when I didn't even know if I could meet or see anyone. Thank you so much. It was a lovely experience.
Hi everyone, I'm Jack.
Hi.
Captain.
Hi, I'm Celestial Brock and we're from, what's our band name?
Cosmic Triceratops.
We are Earthlings of Infinite Love. We are Earthlings of Infinite Love.
We just wanted to say thank you so much for inviting us to be part of this project. It was just wonderful and
ecstatic.
It was ecstatic, and the video that we've got that's been created at the end of it is just stunning.
It's glorious.
It is glorious, like the sun right now.
Mm-hmm.
So mm-hmm. Thank you, Laura. Thank you, Buds and Spawn. Thank you, Arts Council.
Hi, my name's Sophie Cooper, and I really enjoyed being part of the Buds and Spawn live stream. It was really, really interesting for me as a curator and a promoter to engage with people from outside the area that I live in, have a lovely chat with some really interesting new artists. Thank you.
Hey, I'm Christo Squire from Perhaps Contraption. It's been a pleasure to be involved with Buds and Spawn. It's given us a real thrust in a really difficult time to keep on creating new work and connecting with new audiences and impetus to get together and keep building new things. So we really appreciate the support from Buds and Spawn and the Arts Council.
Thank you.